Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I am about to show you a new tool from the people at Sorted. It's a Gmail add-on that converts our email account into a to-do list of sorts. It's almost sacrilege, if the truth be known, but it's a very effective, I think, way that you might consider managing your email. All of us struggle with getting ahead of our email. Sorted might have a solution. When I first took a look at Sorted, the first thing that caught my eye was their logo. It's a squirrel searching for nuts, which I think is a fine metaphor for you and I trying to find the important things that we have to do in our email. Regardless of how diligent we are in email, we all get behind occasionally and get frustrated by email. Well, the folks at Sorted think that there might be a better way to do things, and they think that email is analogous in a lot of ways to tasks. Now, that flies in the face of a lot of modern productivity philosophy, where people like to, where a lot of us like to distance email from the task and to-do list manager and look at it in its own right. Well, Sorted goes to the extreme other end of the spectrum, and it treats emails as tasks and as to-dos, which might well work in your world. Let's take a look at the software itself. All you do to install is you go to Sorted, you sign up, they enroll you, they ask you to download an extension, a browser extension. The whole thing works through the browser extension in Chrome for your Gmail account. This only works for Gmail as far as I know at this point. There is a mobile app which we will look at in the future if we decide that we like the app after we've used it for a little while. But for the most part now, this is designed for Gmail users, I believe primarily in Chrome, although there could well be other extensions available. They only offered me the Chrome download, but I was looking at it in Chrome. Having said all of that, once you've installed it, you are brought in. It then acts as a skin sitting over top of Gmail, and Gmail is always available to you. If I just click here, you can see I've got my good old-fashioned Gmail message right there and available to me. But here it sits in the Sorted interface. Now, we are using my real email account, so I have to apologize. I'll be blurring a little bit more than normal, but I had to show this tool in the real world, as you will see as we move ahead. So essentially, the architecture of the app lays out this way. Down the left-hand side is our inbox. It respects all of Gmail's, if you're using Gmail categories, and they're all available here, so we can jump back and forth into our updates or our social channel, whatever we want, if you sort your email that way within Gmail. But here are all of the messages. You can click on any individual message and you can read that message, and then you can reply to it. So let me just find a fairly benign message here. Here's a message from one of our followers relating to an email that I sent out. You can see that we've got a fairly robust email interface with all of the main activities that we might apply to the email available to us here. Now, one thing I do notice is when I reply to email within this interface is it doesn't automatically archive it. I have to click on the little archive button here in order to archive it once it's all done. But that is basically the email interface. Now, the heart of this tool is these columns here, which are basically to-do lists. They're little task lists that they've named to do and follow up, and then they give you list one and list two. Now, I renamed list one to important stuff. You might name it, they've got in their demo, they've got it named as deals. There's a variety of different things. If you're working on individual projects, you might name it that project name. But regardless of what it's named, what you do is you take any of the emails from your inbox and you drag it in. This is something I have to follow up on. It's an invoice that I want to pay, so I can put this in. I guess I could put it in follow-up. I could also put it in to-do, depending on how I process these lists. So once you've moved it over here, it remains here, and you have the option now with a little drop-down to be able to mark it down as a completed task, to flag it for follow-up. You can edit the title of it. You can do a few other things. So now that email is essentially part of your task and to-do list. If you want to add just a regular old-fashioned task, you just click on the plus, and we have a task that has to be done. Task to do. And once you've got that created, if we click on that, we'll see that we have a pop-up that allows us to make notes on the task, to set reminder dates. So it's a fairly simple, rudimentary task manager as well from this perspective here. Quick access to things like your contacts and calendar within Gmail are all available from this interface screen. They tried and design it so that you will stay in this particular screen as much as possible. But the heart of this system is this concept of finding your different tasks as you go through and then moving them into the appropriate columns and then figuring out how you're going to process those columns as part of your regular workflow. I think it'll work for some people. It won't work for others. I think the way that it probably would work best is if you go through all of your inbox items at once here, migrate all of the content over that you don't want to reply to immediately into these different categories, and then based on your own scheduling is work through one of these categories one at a time or all at once, depending on how you want to do your workflow. I certainly don't hate this interface. I'm kind of liking it a lot. I know some of my colleagues will find this concept of combining tasks and emails as basically heretical as far as modern productivity goes. But I think it's a pretty good idea. I kind of like it, and I'm going to use it for a little while. And if I decide that I like it, I'm going to keep using it because that's how we roll here on Dotto Tech. I hope that you found this video useful. Take a look at Inbox. The links will be in our description below. And if you use it, please let us know in the YouTube comments whether or not this is an app that works for you, or if not, why not? That's all the time that I have for today. There are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. Second is subscribe to our newsletter. Then you'll hear about all of our upcoming events, tutorials, live events, etc. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported through the generosity of you folks at the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, have a look, and discover what perks are available to you should you decide to support Dotto Tech, and those perks be awesome. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.